Hey everybody, it's Dr. Jason Lord from Housecall, and you may have recently read the article that I wrote for Chiropractic Economics called Transferable Practice Equity Value and How to Build It in Your Practice. Well, we wanted to dive a little bit deeper into that subject today, so you found the right video. Here's the challenge, and here's the challenge we all face as chiropractors, right? Your practice is worth a tremendous amount of value to you because it's how you derive your living, your patients are used to the care and the touch of your hands, and it has significantly less value to me, even though I'm a chiropractor with the same exact credentials, because, quite frankly, your patients aren't familiar with me, and there's no guarantee to me, if I was thinking of buying your practice, that your patients would stick around and that the revenue would be stable long after the established doctor like yourself was gone. It's just the inherent weakness of our business model, and it's always been that way since the beginning of time. It's been talked about in terms of something called the goodwill of the practice, and that's always been separated out from the hard, tangible assets like the chiropractic equipment, the tables, the x-ray, the office furniture, and stuff like that. That stuff is easily transferred between owners because it's hard assets that can have a value placed on it and can easily be transferred in terms of ownership. It's the good value, it's the goodwill value of the practice that's always been so elusive to us. That is until now. So the modern day instruments of transferable practice equity value is what that article talked about, and I want to dive a little deeper into those with you right now. The first thing is that I want you to appreciate that you must start with the end in mind. So if you're thinking of exiting practice in the next 5 to 10 years, it's time to begin to ask yourself, what is it that I could do right now? What small changes do I need to make about my practice right now in order to set myself up for a very profitable exit when the time's right? And we say that there's a 5-step, 5-year plan to get this thing done. The first thing you want to do is begin asking yourself, what about my brand is working and what about my brand needs to change? Let me give you a brief example. If the name of your practice is the John Q. Smith Chiropractic Center, unless you can find a new buyer to come along someday when you're ready to retire named John Q. Smith DC, that's a brand name that has difficulty transferring to the next owner. And so what you want to begin to do is ask yourself, what is it about the name of my practice that I'm investing in all this marketing, both online and offline, that might need to change so that when the time comes, all of the cumulative effect of all this marketing and branding toward this name is transferable to the next owner of the practice with ease? So when we say start with your end in mind, it may be time to ask yourself, what is it about my practice's name that I might need to change slightly to make this practice more valuable and have more transferable practice equity value to the next owner? And a simple brand name change requires some new business cards, a little bit of new letterhead, and perhaps a new domain name for your website. But it's maybe the most important step to creating the conditions on the ground for maximum transferable practice equity value. You've got to get that handled first. Plan and brand yourself so that you have a transferable brand to sell to the next owner. Step two is making sure that you build what's called a new patient engine. And here's the thing. Your equipment is valuable to you. It can have a value placed on it. But the flow of new patients that comes into your office is significantly more valuable than all of the equipment and the value of it combined. Now, regardless of who the doctor is, if you can concentrate together, maybe with Housecall, building yourself a new patient engine that brings new patients into that practice, regardless of who the owner is, then that adds tremendous practice equity value for the next owner. Let me give you an example of how. If you've got a domain name that's highly ranked on Google, and that domain name is specifically congruent with the name of your practice, and for every single keyword search imaginable, whether somebody knows they need or are looking for a chiropractor, or whether somebody's in a moment of truth and they say, I don't know who I need, what I need, or where I need to go, but I have low back pain, or maybe they're looking for help with sports injuries. When you own a domain name that a website is highly ranked on Google, for for a broad section of keywords, and it consistently produces new patients for that practice, regardless of who the owner is, that adds tremendous transferable practice equity value. So step two is, in all of your, now that you have your branding and your name set in step one, step two is to make sure that the domain name is congruent with your practice name and that it's consistently producing new patients that find the practice and find the owner of that practice and purchase those services, regardless of who the doctor is who owns the practice. Step number three is we want to build your audience. You know, one of the weaknesses in transferring traditional goodwill is that goodwill only seems to be viably transferred with the existing patients that are under active care at that moment. But all the patients that you've touched throughout your whole career who are just not active right now in the practice, those are very difficult to transfer the new owner because he doesn't get that personal one-on-one introduction. But when you decide right now that you have the end in mind to build that transferable practice equity value and that new patient engine that's going to be driving patients into that practice regardless of owner, then you concentrate on building a social media audience of both your active and inactive patients that stay connected to your office online through social media so that regardless of who the owner of that practice is, this audience that you've taken time to build up over years can be transferred to the next owner of that practice, and they can begin to enjoy new patient flow from that audience of both active and inactive patients by constantly being able to communicate to a large audience of local patients who have had care at one time or another at that particular office. A social media audience has tremendous value. How valuable would it be for you as the potential buyer to look at a practice that has an audience of a local reach of 20 or 30 or 40,000 people that you could say, I don't have to go rent television ads. I don't have to go rent access to the radio. I don't have to buy access to other people's audiences. I can simply come into this practice because over the last 10, 15, 20 years, they've built a large audience of both active and inactive patients that are connected to their friends, family, colleagues, and neighbors. And this is now a practice asset that can transfer to me as the new owner. It adds tremendous transferable practice equity value, and it's not to be taken lightly. I want to point out to you another one here now, the revenue. Not all revenues in a practice are created equal, right? There's service-derived revenue. That's revenue that's exchanged and income that is exchanged for the chiropractic and healthcare-related services that are delivered to patients. And then there's recurrent revenue sources and product revenue sources. And obviously, product revenue sources are powerful because people that buy high-quality branded products that they know they can only buy at your office or buy at a local healthcare professional's office, that adds value because those product sales, particularly if they're consumable and reusable, adds tremendous revenue stream regardless of whether services are being delivered. But even more powerful than that is when they're recurrent revenue sources of product sales, like, for instance, high-quality branded nutritional products that, when they add recurrent revenue to the current revenue base of a practice, that revenue is not treated nearly the same way in the valuation of your practice that simply service revenue is. It's looked at a much higher multiple. So an office that has, say, 10% of its revenue coming in through recurrent nutrition-related revenue of product and supplement sales adds tremendous transferable practice equity value because of the diversified nature of the practice's revenue and because of the fact that that revenue makes the practice's multiple of what it's worth to the next buyer go up dramatically. So step three there is really thinking about how do we diversify the revenue streams of this practice and how do we make sure that we get as much of it in recurrent, high quality, branded products that are outcome focused so that we can enjoy both the income in the short term and then the long term move our PEV variable even higher. And then finally, and this last step is certainly the hardest to do, but it's certainly one of the most important. We call it build your buyer. When you know that you're about 2 to 3 years away from retirement, when you say, look, I want out. I want to go fishing. I want to start my second career. Or it's time for my son or my nephew or my niece to join the practice. 2 or 3 years before you get out, you want to make sure that you build your buyer. And you want to build your buyer because if you do this properly and you transition the patient slowly over time, then in the last year you own that practice, the attrition has been realized, whatever it's going to be. The new doctor coming in there can predict, as well as his bankers or his financial backers, with a high degree of certainty what the recurrent revenue and what the continued service revenue will be in that practice. They will see in action those new patient engines in the form of your website and your social audience generating patients to that practice, regardless of who the audience is. They'll see the diversified revenue streams that are coming into that practice. And it's hard to imagine a scenario where an associate buyer who's had the patients slowly and methodically transitioned over to that new doctor, who's seen an understanding of how the new patients come in, who sees where this revenue is coming from, it's hard to imagine a situation where that associate buyer wouldn't want to pay absolutely top dollar for a practice that's born to succeed for that doctor. So you learn more about some of those strategies for transitioning your transferable practice equity value inside the profit fuel training, but I wanted to give you a brief summary today. If you are thinking about exiting practice in the next 5 years, you must take action now. You must think like a potential buyer would think. You must build your new patient engine that's transferable to the next owner, so you're not just selling a bunch of used equipment, or worse, shutting the doors down, not renewing the lease, and moving all that equipment to your basement. Build yourself true wealth so that when you exit practice, you exit well.